Hello, hello, hello. What is up, everybody? Krillik here. Agrarian skies, too. Good times. Let me first start off by saying I'm sorry if I don't have the same pep and jam as normal. Pep and jam, peanut butter jelly time. Because I'm really not feeling that great. A little dehydrated, a little headache, all that kind of stuff. But it's one of those things, life will go on. I'm not really sick, I don't know what I am. Anyways, we are here in the world. We're doing worldly things, kicking off the world. As you can see, I've kind of done a little bit of building off camera. I've completed out these two sections of farms, which is awesome. That is basically a great starting point. We can do more over there as well. And then that way we can work on the actual general structure of this building. Yeah, building. You heard me right. Building. But anyways, we want to do a couple things before we get going. And to do those things, I want to craft something. Boom. What am I missing? What am I missing? The bucket of redstonian. Bam. Another thruster. And bam. Okay. All right. How do I do this? It's like that. Okay. And my jetpack. Very nice. We are getting ourselves the reinforced jetpack, which basically has almost a billion times more power. Excellent. Very happy about that. Very good. Very good indeed. Now, the next thing that I want to do, let's see. We can mine shiny. Does that mean we can mine ardite? Let's go find out. We're going to go venture into the nether. I want to find a little bit of ardite. I know that like the bad guys won't like me and whatnot, but I don't really care. If they got a beef, I will kick their butts. Okay, I did bring cobble. Good. Let's hover this bad boy. There's some ardite right here. Boom. Boom. Boom, boom. Beautiful. Let's find out. Is it working? It's not working. Okay. I can't do ardite. Confirmed. Cannot do ardite. Okay. So that means we need to upgrade our pickaxe. Which I think I can do. Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm going to do it. So let's go update the pickaxe. Let's get our ardite. Let's get our manulin. Let's complete this tinker's setup. The ardite, cobalt, and manulin. Yes. Alrighty, so we're back. And I want to try a little signalum. Because, well, we can. Now that we have the destabilized redstone and stuff. And I'm pretty sure, if I read this correctly, can do up to cobalt if I just replace the head of the old pickaxe here. So here goes nothing. Let's see if we can actually smelt down a piece of signalum just like a soul. I think we should be able to, but you never know. Maybe not. Maybe they'll be cranky. But yeah, so things are going quite nicely, I must say. We can do signalum, right? Yes, we can. Okay. It is listed in the list. Okay. All right. Is it smelting? It's smelting. Smelting down so far. Yeah. So, it was weird. I was flying around and the server crashed. So, we actually had to teleport me. Meaty Lock had to come on and he had to teleport me back to spawn because I was suspended in the middle of nowhere. Flying around, and it was going to be bad news. It was going to be very bad news. So, we got it all sorted, but it did take about 15-20 minutes. So, if I sound a little off, nice, we have signalum. Give me that pickaxe. Very good, very good. That is what I like to see. Okay. Did that say writable? Write-abler? Write-abler. Why is it ardite? What? What? 51, 53, 608. What? Oh, you can't make that one. Ooh, it's a different one. But that's okay. We can do Ardite then. That's still fine. That'll get us Ardite, which will then be able to get us some Cobalt, right? And then this should be able to repair that up. Good. And then we can replace that pickaxe head. Time to get some good tools. Am I right or am I right? Okay. Boom and boom. Now we can do... Yes. Okay, now we can go and get that Ardite. Okay, here goes nothing. Back to the old nether. Good times in the nether. To be had. There we go. Now, there is another way that you can actually get it. One of the other ways that you could get it is just by sifting soul sand, which, not a bad way at all, just saying. But I kind of wanted to do it this way, because it's way more interesting, in my opinion, to come into the nether and get the loot. So, there's some Ardite that is probably enough. I think I'm going to get a little bit more here. Usually, it is found very commonly up in the air like this. And up high, I find. And the other good thing is, I mean, pigmen don't really bug you when you're mining the Tinker's stuff. So, I'm just going to get myself a little bit more. Maybe scope out, find some cobalt as well, because we are going to need some of that right afterwards. Those look like lapis lazuli. Yes, they are. Okay. So those are lapis lazuli. But, oh, hello. Hi, Ardite. Thank you. Thank you, sir. But yeah, so I'm going to get some resources here. I'm going to do some things. Look at that. There's some cobalt right there. I'm going to get you right away. Alrighty, so I'm back, and I got myself... Oh, not creepers. I was trying to figure out a way to do that, but I did get Ardite as well. So let's claim our extra Ardite. Very nice. Now, Cobalt. This is an interesting guy right here. The only ones that I can see that I can get are the Elementium... or the actual cobalt itself. So I think we're going to have to hold off a little bit on that. But not to worry. We got a lot to do. Oh, we got more Ardite in here. Forgot all about it. There we go. Ardite itself does not mine cobalt. So there's that. Alright, so Elementium is definitely a thing that we could look at. I don't think there's anything else that can actually mine it. Or we might just have to actually produce cobalt, which is also a possibility. So, we'll leave that as is for right now. I wanted to go through the quest book a little bit more with you guys here. There's a few things that we really haven't gotten into at all. The bees stuff, we haven't done any of that, and I don't think we're going to at this point in time. But same thing with the botanical engineering. There's a few things here that we can definitely do to just kind of speed us up on, you know, these quests and seeing what we can actually get. So there are definitely a few here that we can get done. So let's work towards those. Let's get ourselves... Wait a minute, I have a mana spreader. It's right here. I have to craft it? No? Okay. Oh, never mind. It's a redstone mana spreader. Okay. Okay, fair enough. All right. I'll see. There we go. So a redstone mana spreader. Okay, let's look that guy up. While we're here, mana spread. Good, redstone mana spreader, which is just a mana spreader with some redstone. Alright, so we need a little bit of living wood, which we don't have any of. Great. Okay, I see why we haven't really progressed very far in this. We need to get some living wood down. We need to get a whole bunch of resources when it comes to the Britannia world. Oh god, really?
Oh my god, and all that wood. I'm just going to run away. I'm just going to ignore it. It's fine. It's fine. We could probably turn that off. Just saying. Or we need to get a deep storage unit. Maybe we will get a deep storage unit. That might... Or an infinite storage... Yeah, deep storage unit. So let's look at that while we wait for some of this living wood and stuff to go as well. I also want to get into a bit of... the whatchamacallit, oh man, applied energistics, that's the stuff. So mana spreader, living wood, etc. Good. Let's look at the deep storage unit, this guy here. So some reinforced strong boxes, not bad, we can make those. So mostly some hardened glass around some hardened strong boxes, which is tin and invar. Okay, we have lots of invar, and we should have lots of tin. Well, maybe not lots, but we have some. So we need to make four of these guys. Okay, we can do that. That's just fine. Get out of my life. There we go. A little bit of space. All right. So we need four of these guys. So that's, what, eight pieces of wood? One, two, three, four chests. Good. Not too bad, not too bad. We'll put those there. Then it's one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Okay, excellent. So that's the strong box, but then we can also just automatically upgrade them to the hardened. Okay, so that's four hardened strong boxes. Good. Now we need all the glass, the hardened glass. Now for that stuff, I think we've been doing it. Yeah, okay, pulverized, obsidian, and lead. That's right. Okay, let's get some lead. Let's get out our obsidian as well. And let's make some of this stuff too. So yeah, I hope everybody's had a fantastic week. I'm not feeling great today, but that's a different story. Really? Did I just do that? I did not just do that, did I? Acrylic derp, it's fine. But yeah, no, so it's been an interesting day, but you know what, let's finish up this video, do all that kind of stuff. Okay, so where are we at here? Right here, we need to pulverize up some obsidian. Okay, let's do 8 for right now. Sure. Do we have this all wired in? I think we do, right? Yeah, we do. Okay, good. And I'll put the lead in the induction smelter here. And we can then proceed to finish this up because we need 16 hardened glass. And then for the resonant energy cell frame, we need some enderium and we need more hardened glass as well. So we actually need 20 total. And enderium we can make pretty easily. If I'm not mistaken, we did it before in the casting table. But we could do this as well now, the pyrothium with enderium blend. So some tin, some silver, and some shiny metal with some resonant ender, which, again, we have. Okay, so which one's which here again? That's redstone. That's there is the resonant ender. Good. Let's get that. Let's get our tin, silver, etc., going. You know, the other thing that I really wanted to get, and I think we will this episode, we're going to try to get a few things done here, so bear with me. Let's get a little bit more of this going as well. Boom, boom, boom. Good. Good enough. Okay. We can put that away for right now as well. So I have the tin. We only need 3 though. Yeah. 3 tin is what we require. We don't need any lead, but we do need 1 silver and 1 shiny. Okay, and then we'll pulverize all that down and we'll get our enderium blend. Now, the other thing that we needed was the pyrothium. Now, pyrothium is sulfur, pulverized coal, redstone, and blaze powder. So, we should have some sulfur somewhere here. Right there. Good. We should also have some pulverized coal right there. beautiful. So there's those two. And then just a piece of redstone and blaze powder. And that should give us the pyrothium that we need. Good. All right. We are cruising. We are motoring. So one of the things I really want to get as well is just a better way to get around our base. I mean, we're doing decently with the jetpack and just walking around and all that kind of stuff. But there's got to be better ways to maneuver and to transport around the base. So I think we're going to look into some of that as well. Let's just disable that for right now. And we'll pulverize up the shiny. Oh, I guess we only needed 2 tin, didn't we? Oh, well. 2 tin. Yeah. And a silver. Come on, pulverizer. Hurry up, please. Thank you. And the piece of silver. While we're waiting for our glass. Oh, man. I tell you. Not too much crazy things going on, you know? I mean, a lot of people have all this cool stuff that's going on and this and that. Nothing too crazy for me. Pretty par for the course these days. Just kind of doing my thing, right? So we got that. We got our pyrothium. That should get us some of our enderium. Very good. We can make our strong boxes. The reinforced variety. Very good. Like so. And we need to get our electrum. I really wish we had Ender IO. Staff of Traveling would be awesome. Wouldn't it? I think it would be amazing. So I guess we could go with, we need to get some electrum. 1, 2, 3, 4. And what else do we need? A diamond. We need a diamond. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, and 1 diamond. Okay, good. We should have everything else ready to go for this setup. So let's make it. Let's get it done. Let's color and yeah, deep storage unit. I'm pretty excited, actually. I know I don't sound it because I'm not feeling all that great. But I am actually really excited. So, there we go. There's our enderium around the sides. We have that around with the resonant or the reinforced strong boxes. And some plastic sheets. Really? I need one more piece still. Oh, dang. You know, I completely forgot that we had this fissure going. Oh, look at that, a plastic sheet. Nice. We do have plastic sheets somewhere here, right? Right? Somewhere? Two. Okay. There. We can make more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. All right. 4 plastic sheets. And deep storage unit. Of course, it's not going to work because it doesn't like me. It's fine. And the 4 plastic sheets all the way around gives us the deep storage units. Now, these are actually part of a quest, so let's go into that and claim it. Because why not? Reward bag. Nice. Very nice. Okay. Reward bag. Very good. Let's see what type. Epic. All right. Seafood stuff. Okay. That is interesting. And I'll leave it at that. Very, very interesting. I'm not sure if there's really anything at all that we can actually do with them. But it's an interesting reward, I guess. So we have the deep storage unit. So now we need to basically convert that over and get over to fixing our tree farm. Alrighty, so we've added the deep storage unit, so nothing should actually come out of there anymore. It should try to find its way into the barrel first, and then if not, it should go into the deep storage unit here. 365, I assume that's going to start chopping down, and we should see it automatically go into the deep storage unit as a valid source. Is it? Yes? No? These pipes take too long. Well, it hasn't shot out the backside yet. So, okay, where is it going? Is it still in the pipe? What? There we go. Yeah, it was still in the pipe. So there we go. It's now filling up the deep storage unit. So we should be good. We shouldn't have that problem again. Alrighty, now it's time to make our spreader, just like so, and a redstone spreader. You know, I don't really see the need for ever doing these, but, you know, it's one of those things, I guess. We completed that reward, so we can get just another mana spreader. I mean, I guess that's an advantage. Elven, we are not quite there yet. The botanical brewing, though, can we do that one yet? I'm not sure, actually. Yeah, I'm not too sure. Let's see. The botanical brewery. So, brewing stand, a rune of mana, a block of mana steel, and some living rock. Oh, wow. That's pretty expensive. So, let's see what we can do here. We haven't even built an altar yet, have we? So, an altar, let's find it here. Nope. You know, it's kind of funny that they don't need you to build an altar first. Isn't that kind of strange? I think that's a little strange. So, a runic altar is basically a mana pearl or a mana diamond on with some living rock. So, we have a ton of pearls, so let's do a mana pearl. And we will get ourselves our first altar. Very nice. Not bad at all. You know, all things considered, though, our mana generation is not going to be up to par at all to basically carry on much further. So, I think what that means is we're going to need to... Let's see. Yeah, we're going to need to definitely kick some of this into a little bit of a higher gear. For sure. Yeah, we'll just place those down for right now. Because I don't really have anywhere else for them to go. We don't have very much mana at all. That is not good. Okay. So, we have a runic altar. So, from there we could make our rune of the mana. But again, look at how much that takes. I don't think we're in the position to do the botanical brewing at this point in time. We could look at the rune of water and rune of fire. We could make some of those basic runes. Rune of water is very easy. Fishing rod, sugar cane, bone meal, and some mana steel. Let's see about making that first and foremost here. So let's do that. Let's put the spare deep storage units in there with all of our other stuff. And let's figure out if we can get this thing done. So we need three of you. We need a piece of bone meal. That's probably the easiest thing for us to get. We need a piece of sugar cane as well. And I don't think it can take a damaged fishing rod. If I remember correctly. I don't believe it can. Oh, maybe it can. Maybe we can get this to work with that crummy fishing rod. So that's good. And then we're going to need a lever to give this guy a redstone signal to start transferring the power. All right. I guess we'll just put it right there. There we go. You can see it's starting to, it started to fill up the altar, right? Good. Good. All right. Now we need the mana steel. 1, 2, 3. Good. Oh, beautiful. We had enough. Good. All right. And hit it with the one. Uh-huh. See? See what I was saying? We can't. All right. So this fishing rod does not work. We need to make a new one. Alright, so a fresh rod, hitting it with the wand, and it's starting to go. So always make sure you have some living rock as well, ready to go. Why aren't you... Does that honestly, like, not do anything? At all? I have a feeling it's not what I think it is. It's fine. Alright, I'm mumbling. I apologize. There we go. Let's shoot some of that mana in and get this rune starting to create. Is that actually like a redstone pulse or something? Anyways, it's fine. So we're making our mana, our rune of water. Very nice. While we're waiting for that, the rune of fire is some more mana steel, some nether wart. Ooh. Gunpowder and nether brick. Aha, it's done. So we drop the living rock on it, hit it again with the wand of the forest, and we have our runes of water. Very good. The rune of fire, I think that we should be able to make that as well. Yeah, we're doing okay. I think we're doing fine for all that stuff. So let's get ourselves, let's put that away. Let's get ourselves some nether brick. Is that just the netherrack? Is that the only way you can do it? Okay. Nether brick. Good. Do we have nether wart? I really do not want to go into the nether. Every time I do, it seems to screw me up. Big time. Do we not have any nether wart? Uh-oh. Ruh-roh. That's not good. Did I miss it? Okay. Not good. Not good at all. Can we make nether wart somehow? We can with that. And then it's just sieving. Okay. Alright, let's get some soul sand then, I guess. And start sieving. Alrighty, and the rune of fire is now being crafted. I see that there's a zombert in with our enderman over there. That's fine. We have everything prepared to get our rune of fire, and we'll complete that quest. And then we're going to look at some way to get around the base just a little bit quicker, I think. You know, and that'll probably wrap up the video. But, you know, all good things come to an end, right? There we go, rune of fire as well. Let's see, we got a rune of spring. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Okay, that's it though. All right. Really, really exciting. Yeah. Yeah, really, really exciting there. These quests, man, they just blow your mind, right? All right, let's just throw them in there for right now. I also have a heat sand here that I got from sieving, but we have a whole bunch over there from the sludge boiler, so I think I'm going to kill that too. So, let's talk about a way to transport around a little bit, okay? Now, translocation plates from thermal expansion will teleport things on contact, okay? And you need a multimeter while sneaking to configure. But they're not that difficult to make. Basically, some of that resonant ender on a plate frame. But the plate frame is actually decently expensive with the signalum and whatnot. And signalum blend, again, not all that easy to make. Copper and silver, not overly expensive, but just kind of a pain to make these things. So, let's make, for right now, I think we're going to need about four of them. So, we're going to need some more hardened glass. We're going to need about, 16 signalum. Yikes. That's fun. Right? Yeah. So, 4 times 3, 12, and 4 silver. Okay. Let's get that going, I guess. 12 copper. Good. That will do the signalum. And we needed the invar for 9, 12. Good, good, good. Now we do have some signalum here. I think I'm just going to make all new though. We might as well save that for another time. And then what was the other thing? Oh yes, the hardened glass. So we need some more obsidian. 4 and I can never remember how much lead. So let's take all that over there. And let's get these plate frames made up. Now, obviously, we have the resonant ender now from our previous endeavors here. So that's good. Let's... Game? Uh-oh. We're lagging. Not good. Not good at all. Uh-oh.
Is the server crashing? Alrighty, let's get some signalum here. Very good, very good. Get it all. Just get it all. Beautiful. Alright, so 16 pieces of signalum. Very nice. Let's get that guy set back up, and let's smelt down that. I also have our hardened glass here, so we should be good to go on making these plate frames as soon as our signalum's done. Not bad at all. You know, the recipe's not too shabby. It's a little bit interesting, but, you know, one of those things. There we go. There's our Invar and the signalum. These things are going to be awesome. Just saying, because they're going to help us teleport around the base. Now, we also needed a multimeter? Multimeter, yes, from thermal expansion. Copper, lead, electrum, hey? Okay, not the worst. A little annoying, but not the worst. Good, we got the plate frames. Let's start filling them up with resonant ender to get our translocation plates. This is awesome. I'm really looking forward to having these around. I've seen other guys use them with the movement plates, which are really cool too. But the way I figure it is I will just do like that. Whoa! Okay. It teleported me up. I hope this can teleport us directionally. Not just up. I guess we'll find out together, won't we? Let's quickly make ourselves that multimeter to see if we can't configure what we need to properly. I don't believe I have any electrum gears. I do not. So we're going to have to smelt it down and all that kind of stuff. Good times. But it shouldn't be too bad. Let's put that in there as well. And the hardened glass, we're kind of getting full everywhere. Our storage situation is a little bit questionable. Just saying. What? Sanguimancy. The block is a lie. Okie dokie. Alright, good. Alrighty, so we've made the multimeter. Let's get on over there. And what did it say again? Use a multimeter while sneaking to configure. Okay, so I'm wondering, we need to go south. Alright, so can we actually set this up and configure it correctly? Okay, so distance is 16. Okay, so I can reduce that, but is there no way? Okay, there we go. No, that's the wrong way. Like so. Okay, so this'll shoot me 16 blocks to that direction. Okay. These things only go 16 blocks, eh? Okay. Alright. To right here. Okay. So then if we put another one down, where would that shoot us to? That's gonna shoot us into the void. Yeah, that's not really going to work, is it? Well, I'm kind of actually disappointed by these things. I was expecting better stuff. Now, I guess one of the things that's good is they would be really good for teleporting vertically. But I don't know about the whole if they work all that great. Because, you know, that's not that fantastic, really. What other plates are there? There's the redstone plate. Okay, not necessary. The impulse is the one that shoots you forward. And that's just energized glowstone. Yeah, I don't know. Like, this teleport one, it's not that great, is it? It's not going to get us around that much faster at all. I mean, I guess we could position it along here a little bit. So let's see if we wanted to land there. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So it'd be right there that we'd have to place it. So if I place this down here,
It takes us right to there.
Okay.
All right. And then from there, if I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 or so. I guess we could do 12. Configure it here. And we'll go, let's go 13. And nope. There we go. So that takes us to the daisy. So we need to go 12. It was 12. Okay. So 12 blocks. This should work to... Okay. And they don't even chain. All right. Well, these things, I don't know. A little bit of a bust. Let me know down in the comments what you think about these translocation plates. I mean, there's a use for them, for sure. But the fact that they don't connect and like daisy chain you is a little bit puzzling for me. And the other thing is I was expecting ones that we could get maybe a bit more of a range to. So I'm not sure overall how I feel about them. Just saying. But anyways, you guys can let me know down in the comments section of the video. I thank you guys so much. I appreciate all the love that you guys give me all the time. It's wonderful. I really, really do. All right. So next episode, I think we're going to start dabbling into applied energistics. Yeah, I think so. That's silly. Okay. Unless I do it 11. What happens when I do it 11 and there's a block there? Let's figure that out. Okay. Hold on. I'm distracted. Let's go 11. It won't teleport you. Interesting, because there's a block. Okay, so if we go here instead, and this goes then like 10 blocks. Okay, and then this would be 12, 13, 14, 14. Or 13. 13? So I step on that. It takes me to the daisy. Yeah, it's 14. Okay. So I guess as long as you're still running forward. Yeah, see, it's not fast enough to trigger. Anyways, bye-bye for now. Make sure you leave a like. Make sure you comment. All that kind of stuff. Thank you so much. I love you all. Have a great day.